I am Dr. Kavitha Yadav, Assistant Professor, GFGC Rajajinagar. This session is with regarding to swabs. So we will know more about swabs. Firstly, we will know the meaning of swab. See, swab is defined as an instrument that allows the exchange of one instrument for another between the parties concerned. It started initially in the stock market when one security was exchanged for another with the objective of changing the maturity or quality of stock held. However, the concept expanded to cover foreign exchange as well as currency risk. Hence, swap is defined as an agreement between two parties to exchange any type of asset, cash flow, environment liability or payment for another. Okay, swaps can be based on interest rates, stock indices, foreign currency exchange rates, as well as commodity prices. See, swap is a method of reducing financial risk too. So what are the features of swap? Let us know now. Firstly, it is a forward contract, we tell. A swap is nothing but a combination of forwards. So it has all the properties for forward contract. Second, double coincidence of want. Swap requires that two parties with equal and opposite needs must come into contract with each other. Then the third one is comparative credit advantage. See, floating rate debts will enter into a swap agreement to exchange floating rate interest with the borrowers enjoying comparative advantage. So floating rate comparative advantage can be used when there is swap agreements. Then we have got flexibility. Flexibility in short term, we can tell in short term market, the lenders have the flexibility to adjust the floating interest rates, that is short term interest rates, according to the conditions prevailing in the market as well as the current financial position of the borrower. Hence, the short-term floating interest rate is cheaper to the borrower with the credit rating when compared with fixed rate of interest. Next feature is necessity of an intermediary. See, swap requires the existence of two counterparties with opposite but matching needs. This has created a necessity for an intermediary to cancel both the parties. By arranging swaps, these intermediaries can earn income too. So financial companies, particularly banks, can play a key role in this innovative field by virtue of their special position in the financial market and their knowledge of the diverse needs of the customers. Next feature is settlement. So, though a specified principal amount is mentioned in the swap agreement, there is no exchange of principal. But on the other hand, a ream of fixed rate interest is exchanged for a floating rate of interest. And thus, there are streams of cash flows rather than single payment. Then it's long-term agreement, we tell. Generally, forwards are arranged for short period only. Long dated forward rate contracts are not preferred because they involve more risks like risk of default, risk of interest rate fluctuations, etc. But swaps are in the nature of long term agreement and they are just like long dated forward rates contracts. Thus, exchange of a fixed rate for a floating rate requires a comparatively longer period. Then if we have to know what are the risks associated with swaps, firstly, swap administration. See, as with every other financial instrument, an international framework for administration must be constructed. Due to their relative complexity, the administration of swap contracts is often done by the fund manager, investment bank or investment consultant who must communicate the issues to the client. See, specific administration issues would include monitoring the efficacy of the swaps in matching asset and liability duration, and also management of collateral and restructuring the swaps as required when the liability benchmark changes. The next risk associated is market value risk. See, in most cases, the value of swap is zero in the beginning. Over time, the value of the swap will either increase or decrease negative as rates fluctuate. However, as long as the asset value remains constant in relation to its liabilities, as rate fluctuates, the risk of a decrease in the value of swap is not relevant. There is no net effect on the solvency of the fund. The third one is the credit risk. See, if the value of the swap becomes positive, then there is a credit risk exposure to the counterparty of the swap. In effect, the counterparty owes the other party the positive value of the swap. So these are some of the basics that you have to know with regarding to the concept called swap. Thank you.